Dimitrov serving first at the bottom of your picture to get us started.
Love.
Statement of intent right from the start from the Bulgarian. Just missed it. He tried to seal the love service game to start with. Not quite able to do that. Certainly a very positive start from Dimitrov.
Hold!
40-30.
Follows it up there with the double fault. All of a sudden, it's not quite so comfortable in this opening game.
Hold!
That's the job done in the end, though. That was some way to win it as well. Powerful forehand.
First game.
Hit with real accuracy as well as power to close out that opening game, get his name on the board. Certainly something of the showman. Looking to entertain this crowd again. His two matches earlier this week, albeit in defeat against both Tipsarevic and Djokovic, have been thoroughly entertaining affairs. The expectation is this will be no different. First service game then for Janovic. Interesting to see how he adapts to the grass courts. Too much experience of this surface. Shot to prominence, of course, with his run to the final last year of the Paris Masters, defeating five top 20 players en route, including Andy Murray. Only the second man to reach the final of a Masters tournament as a qualifier. That catapulted him towards the world's top 20. Just two places outside that now. Left himself with work to do in this opening service game, though. Facing two break points already. Went all the way up to 26 in the world at the end of last year with that run in Paris. Broke the top 30 for the first time. Built on that this year. Saves the first of the break points. Hasn't yet built on that final appearance, though, which so surprised everybody in Paris. It remains the only final that he's reached on the ATP Tour.
Love 40.
He can't quite control the volley, so Janovic broken in his first game. Dimitrov goes 2-love ahead. Perfect start for the Bulgarian here. So he looks for his first win of the week. Decent doubles player, Janovic, which would suggest the volleying on the grass courts could suit his game. Actually reached the doubles final earlier this year at Indian Wells. His first ATP final in that particular form of the game. He's not yet really got going here. It was a much better point from Janovic.
15-0.
Just controlled the overhead and kept it in. Very much in charge of the point from the off. Really solid start from Dimitrov, though.
30-50.
Showing the full range of shots so far. Killed that one stone dead, as he needed to do. Can't quite get going yet. Understandable that it is his first match here this week. Or is Dimitrov already used to the courts, the way that they're playing? And he's used that to his advantage by strolling into a 3-love lead already. He's used to the conditions, to the court, to the crowd. It's at home yesterday against Djokovic, even in defeat. We'll see this as a much more presentable opportunity to get the victory. Despite the fact they're the same age, they're very similar in the world rankings. They have never met on the ATP tour before, as I mentioned. So not overly familiar, maybe, with each other's games. A chance for both to get some vital playing time in before Wimbledon. And the courts, as I mentioned before, that are built to the same specifications as they'll encounter at the All England Club. Dimitrov seeded at 29 at Wimbledon this year. Tough opening draw he's got actually in the first round against Simone Bolelli. And that draw was made this morning. Potential third round meeting with Juan Martin Del Potro. We saw on this court just a few minutes ago. That's better from Janovic.
15-love.
He's in the bottom half of the draw at Wimbledon. He'll actually play a British wild card in the first round. Well, Jerzy Janovic, he's up against Kyle Edmund. We're in the same quarter of the draw as Rafa Nadal. And also, of course, Roger Federer. Oh! It's the quarter that everybody, I guess, would have wanted to avoid. Janovic has found himself in the middle of it. Looking to get his first game on the board here this afternoon.
40-50.
Every chance to do so now.
T30.
That's his first double.
Net first serve. Okay, Janowicz
follows up the double fault with the ace, though, to get his first game on the board, and he'll feel all the better for that.
Dimitrov leads 3-1.
Still a break behind in this opening set, but he's up and running at last. Reacted really well there, Dimitrov.
15-love.
Not yet been tested on his own serve, though. Player whose year began in style with that run to the final in Brisbane. Been as good as it's got in terms of progress deep into a tournament this year. There have been some notable results for him, though.
Game,
Dimitrov. That is the love service game. Mixing good touch. It was Andy Murray that beat Dimitrov him in that Brisbane final. Just on the line, I think, here. It was certainly a close call. The deciding point of the game. Didn't build on that fine form in Brisbane at the first Grand Slam of the year, shortly afterwards at the Australian Open, where he lost in the first round to Julien Beneteau, but gradually improved since then. He made the semi-finals in Rotterdam, lost to Del Potro. Took Djokovic to beat him at Indian Wells and Murray in Miami. Nadal in Monte Carlo. So when he has gone out of the Masters tournaments, it's only been to the big names, really. Actually beat Novak Djokovic in Madrid and then failed to really build on that and lost in the third round to Stanislav Wawrinka back in May. Djokovic, of course, taking his revenge at Roland Garros a couple of weeks ago and then beating him here yesterday.
Time.
Dimitrov getting a bit of experience on the grass, though. Two matches he had at Queen's Club. Mentioned the defeat to Leighton Hewitt, where he lost in straight sets, 6-4, 6-3. Prior to that, he'd won a final set tiebreak, though, against Dudi Sailer. Still a relatively alien surface for both of these players, though. Janowicz serving at 1-4.
Net Fesser.
Didn't quite get down quickly enough to that one. Huge frame of Janowicz, 6'8", the tallest on the tour. Actually, even taller than Del Potro, who we saw in the first match. And there's the disadvantage, maybe, of 15, being 30. That tall on the grass court. Just missed 15, that one 40. As well, and further problems for Janovic here. He will face two break points. Dimitrov with a chance of the double break. First one saved. But he's missed that one. And it's all going the way of Grigor Dimitrov here. That is the double break of serve for a 5-1 lead in this first set. The other side of this event, isn't it? Busy week here for Dimitrov, but serving for this first set already.
15 left.
Hasn't really settled into any sort of a rhythm so far, hasn't Jetsi Janovic. Still struggling to find his range. And it looks like he will be a set behind before he's ever really got started. Two set points. Just tightened up a little there.
40-30.
But has another chance to close out the set. And double quick time, really. 40 done so there. Was called wide.
Juice.
Might have cost him. Second set point save by Janovic.
Advantage, Dimitrov.
Set point number three.
Game.
And this time he does enough. Big round of applause for Grigor Dimitrov, rapidly becoming a popular figure here this week. And he takes the first set against Jetsi Janovic, 6-1. Won't be getting too carried away, though, because he has won the first set in each of the first two matches that he's played here this week and went on to lose both of those. Although this one was much more comfortable against Janko Tipsarevic, where he won that first set on a tiebreak, lost the second in similar fashion, and then lost the match tiebreak 10-4. And then yesterday against Djokovic, Dimitrov took the first set right at the end of it, 7-5, lost the second 3-6, and the match tiebreak 10-6. Hence, he is still waiting for his first win of the week, but he will certainly feel this is his best chance of getting it. It was a dominant first set of tennis against Janovic. He never really settled for whatever reason. Wasn't given too many chances to settle, in fairness, by Dimitrov. He has taken advantage of his familiarity with the settings this week. Mainstay player making his debut here. Just had the one match at Janovic on the grass in the current season at Halle. He lost a couple of tie breaks and a three-set defeat to Mirza Bazic. Dimitrov is enjoying himself.
Second set. Jerzy Janovic to serve. Thank you.
As it has to be said, are most of the onlookers here. Janovic serving first, start of the second set.
Love 15.
Not the statement of intent he was hoping for to begin the set, though.
Love 30.
Looking to start this set, how he finished the last one, Dimitrov, and he has a chance of doing so here. Putting the pressure on the Janovic serve again. Much better serve this time from the pole when he needed it.
15-30.
Even draws the applause from his opponent. Disguised the shot really well. Perfectly placed. This is a decent response. So he's dropping the first couple of points of this set. Three in a row for Janovic to turn the game around. So important, you feel, given the manner of which he, in which he lost that first set, that he starts the second on the front foot.
Juice.
But he can't finish the game off there. We'll see that as a missed chance to do so as well.
Advantage, Janovic.
Again, just can't get over the line in this game. Yes.
Advantage.
It was more threatening, I think, to the crowd.
Dimitrov.
Famously close to the court here. This time it's the break point.
Advantage.
But a kick to the serve.
Juice.
Can see what he was trying to do there. It was instinctive from Dimitrov. He just couldn't quite control it. Back to juice we go. It's the longest game of the match already. Another fine serve into the body.
Advantage, Janowicz.
Ever the showman, isn't it?
Game Janowicz.
He's given him the game. Couldn't get the serve back from
first game, second serve.
Beyond the baseline in the extreme. But Janowicz holds. Fiercely competitive first set of tennis where Dimitrov took charge. He's maybe allowed concentration to waver a little here. All of a sudden it's a very different type of contest, isn't it? The grunt's proving particularly effective.
Love 15.
And again, should have been doing that from the start, maybe.
Love 30.
Come on! Found his way past the wiggle this time.
15-30.
Not this time.
30.
Deadpan, isn't it?
T40.
So the break point. Doesn't appear too concerned, does he? Not quite.
Juice.
for all the mannerisms and the
advantage Janovic.
Imitations. It's actually probably the best tennis that Janovic has played in the game. Another break point.
Advantage, Janovic.
Double four sets up break point number three. The break. Two love lead for Janovic.
Janovic
might be taking the pressure out of the situation and allowing himself to enjoy it a bit more. Has worked in his favour there. Playing the joker. At the same time, coming up with a series of winners. Some of these rallies still very high quality, and Janovic 15. Now is finding his best form. Dimitrov may be taking his eye off the ball. The point may be that there's a better finish than that. Some high quality stuff up until this. It was far too casual from Janovic. Still a fair bit behind that second serve, wasn't there? Although it was a long way long.
15-30.
But only the line judge rather than Dimitrov that was threatened by that one. Absolutely fabulous point. Well, they might be playing the fool at times and joking around on the court, but that was high quality stuff. It really was. Wonderful rally.
30.
A little bit of everything in that.
T40.
One extreme to the other, though, and the double fault sets up a break point for Dimitrov.
Juice.
Another really big serve, though. That will be a big asset to him. on the grass courts. And at Wimbledon next week, maybe.
Advantage, Janovic.
Made the third round at Wimbledon last year. His best performance. Never been further in a Grand Slam. He has been to the third round in three of the four majors now. Including the Australian and the French this year. His chance. If we work at the net from Dimitrov, from both of them for a while. Just tried to be a little too cute, and the angle was too acute. So back to juice we go.
Advantage, Dimitrov.
And we had the chance to serve out the game and go three love ahead. He now faces another break point. Chance for Dimitrov to get back on terms, or back on serve at least in the set. Chance he takes because of the error at the net from Janovic. So he does get off the mark in this second set now, the Bulgarian.
Janovic leads 2-1.
And for all the fooling around, I think Janovic will be disappointed with himself at the end of that game. And his chances for a 3-love lead, and then missed a fairly straightforward volley at the net to concede the game in the end. It is great entertainment for everybody here, isn't it? Rapidly becoming a fan's favourite is Dimitrov, but Janovic is playing his part in the entertainment as well. Certainly this set is shaping up to be much more closely contested than the first. Bit of breeze around. Not unwelcome. It's been a fairly humid week. Thankfully, the rain that threatened at the start of the day's play has thus far, touching wood, stayed away. One more match still to come on this court after this one. Dolgopolov against Querrey, but it is Dimitrov serving here to try and level up the second set at 1-2. Back on serve now after that break. It's back in the zone again. Got away with one, but made the most of it. Well, we saw yesterday how he and Djokovic were only too keen to involve the ball girls in proceedings. Just missed. valiant attempt.
40 love.
Just a little off balance there. So again, failed to close out the love service game. They've been few and far between. Truly done.
40-30.
Left that to the last moment. Dimitrov had done well to actually reach that one, but it was ultimately in vain. What a double act, aren't they? Well, that's three excellent points on the bounce from Janovic, from 40 love to juice.
Juice.
And they are joking around. It seems to bring the best out of Janovic, whereas Dimitrov maybe loses concentration a little.
Advantage, Dimitrov.
Forced out too wide. Again, he can't see the game through here.
Juice.
That's a more competitive affair in the second set. In terms of the closeness between the two, it's more as we expected it to be, I guess, after that fairly one-sided first set. That's beautiful. Certainly worthy of the applause.
Dimitrov. Game, Dimitrov.
And sees it out with the ace this time to get us back on terms in the second set at 2-2. Had to work for it. Comes from two love down in the set to square it again.
They
say you can never really claim a break of serve until you've held the next game to back it up, and Dimitrov has done that. And is looking to
15-0.
Continue the momentum now, forcing the error. Mentioned how Janovic reached a couple of junior Grand Slam finals during his career. Well, Dimitrov, of course, won a couple at Wimbledon and the US Open back in 2008. Former world number one in the juniors. Really taking that on now on the senior stage. It was a perfectly placed serve.
40-50. Janovic.
Good service game from the pole. Well, the concession of just the 1 point. And now he's back in front at 3-2 in the second set.
Janovic leads 3 games to 2.
Well, it's no wonder, is it? The event is so popular with so many of the world's best players. Fairly relaxed, informal way to prepare for Wimbledon, but the tennis is of the highest quality at times. Can see just from looking at that he's been given a real old workout here, which is exactly what he'd have been hoping for. Decent clay court season for him. Mentioned that third round appearance, his best at Roland Garros. Prior to that in Rome in the Masters, went to the quarterfinals. It took Roger Federer to stop him, and he claimed some notable scalps along the way, including Joe Wilfried Tsonga and Richard Gasquet, beating two top 10 players en route to the last eight. Really was the high point of his clay court season. Determined to enjoy his time on the grass, it seems. Immediately the applause from Dimitrov. That was simply too good. And again, for all the fooling around, the quality was outstanding. Once again, it's bringing the best out of Janovic. Just couldn't quite make the most of a little bit of fortune in the build-up there.
15-30.
Should have put the point away really there, should Janovic, but it didn't matter.
Deal. 40-30.
A couple of big serves from Dimitrov. For all the clowning around after those two defeats earlier this week, you won't want to lose this. Particularly having been so dominant in the first set. But whatever happens, he will take a lot from that. He didn't hear the call.
Game, Dimitrov.
There wasn't a call. He's not sure about that one, is he? Not sure he was either, but he'll take it. Levels it up. 3-all second set. Both players were expecting the serve to be called out. It wasn't. Valiant attempt to get there. He was just asking too much.
30-love.
One thing they don't want to do, of course, with Wimbledon just days away, is to risk injury. Both fully committed here. One of the best serves that we've seen from the pole. There's been a few decent ones in this contest. 40-50. Persistence in the end pays off. Dimitrov takes the point despite being on the back foot for most of it. Some brilliant defensive work in there.
40-30.
Kept him alive and eventually profits from the Janovic error. That's a gift for Dimitrov. All of a sudden he's not smiling now after that.
Advantage,
compliment
Janovic.
To an extent return though. Dimitrov will be disappointed not to have made the volley.
Net for sir. engage.
Soft hands and smart reactions at the net from Janovic. Ensure he holds on to the serve. 4-3, his lead.
Janovic
on serve.
Leads 4-3.
In the second set. A lot of the games, though, very closely contested. Now, a lot of them going to juice. That was an awkward one for Dimitrov. Mentioned that he doesn't want to pick up any injury ahead of Wimbledon. He doesn't look too concerned by almost doing the splits there. He has been made to work hard and chase down a lot in the second set in particular. But content enough to do so. Having a sunbathing going on. It is effectively the best part of the day weather-wise now. If they can bask in the sunshine, then why can't yet to Janovic? Well, here it comes. The lotion's been applied as well. This is brilliant. Clearly a close friendship between the two players. We'll make it an unusual picture for the photo album, won't it? Is he calling for the towel now? The ball girl's not getting any closer. Time being called of real inconvenience to Janovic. Brilliant how he can just flick the switch, isn't it?
Love 50.
Playing up to the crowd, and as soon as the serve comes down, he's straight onto it. That's good.
15-0.
Just clip the inside of the line.
Thirty-40.
I'll break point. If Janovic is able to take this, he will serve for the set to try and take us to the match tiebreak.
Juice.
Never really got the chance, though, on the break point, did he? Dimitrov aces it, but still with work to do. And he was made to work, but he put himself in the right place. Controls the advantage, winning volley. Probably doesn't fancy the match tiebreak after what's happened this week.
Game, Dimitrov.
Losing the two of them. But he's back on terms in the second set here. That's four games all now. On we go. Took himself out of a little bit of a hole there, saving the break point.
Love.
Janovic is not hanging around in this game. The ninth of the second set. Gets to 40 love already. Emphatic. Takes him to within a game of the second set. This was some way to seal the love service game. Couldn't get near it, Dimitrov, that. And the Bulgarian will serve now to try and stay in this second set. If unsuccessful, we will go to that match tie break. If you were with us a little earlier, you might have seen in the game between Del Potro and Gasquet, which went the Frenchman's way. Still have Sam Querrey and Alexander Dolgopolov to come on this court after this as well. Currently getting their money's worth now, certainly, after the first set, which was fairly one-sided and straightforward for Dimitrov. It's been much closer. Rather more jovial as well. The second set of tennis. It's not over yet. Far from it, still on serve at 5-4 to Janovic. But I was going to say the pressure reverts to Dimitrov. There's not really any pressure in this sort of situation, is there? It enables both players to really express themselves and for the crowd as well, and us to see a side of the players we don't often get to see on the tour. We have two real characters out there on the court. Thirteen courts on the complex in total, by the way. Just got a glimpse there of the setup here at Stoke Park. Three D glasses, I think he was joking. Oh, how about that? Brilliant from both of them. Did so well to reach this, but how's that for showmanship? I don't think either of them would necessarily want this to finish, though. Having too much fun out there, aren't they?
Game, Dimitrov.
And so it's Dimitrov who holds the love. Told you there was no pressure.
Five games all.
So on we go, 5-5, second set.
15 love.
Servers certainly dominating at the moment. Anything, that serve is getting better and better. Bigger and bigger. Another love game. We've been having a conversation midpoint.
Janowicz leads 6 games to 5.
That's 3 games in succession where the receiving player has failed to win a point. Once more, takes Janowicz within a game of the set. And there is, again, a glimpse of a picturesque setting of Stoke Park. 27-hole championship golf course in the background amongst the 300 acres of Parkland Estate. Becoming a real date on the social calendar, isn't it? This tournament in its 12th year now. Shouldn't be on the phone. Maybe after a refill. So for the second time in the sets, Dimitrov serves to save it.
15 love.
Everything into that one.
30 left.
As they get ready for the next match.
What?
Might have thought they'd be on court by now, given the way the first set went, but very different story in the second. Brilliantly done from Janowicz, worthy of the applause, certainly.
30-15.
Interesting to see if the players will be willing to risk some of the shots that we're seeing today in the high pressure of Wimbledon next week, when the circumstances are rather different. If they execute them as well, then no reason why they shouldn't.
40-50.
The first point against the serve for quite some time, but Dimitrov comes straight back again. 2 points here to take us to the tiebreak.
40-50.
Unorthodox but effective. 6-6 tiebreak in the second set.
6-6 second set tiebreak.
If Dimitrov comes through it, he wins. If Janowicz comes through it, we go to another tiebreak. There's the pole to serve first. Mixed fortunes in the tiebreak so far this week.
Janowicz.
At the Boodles for Dimitrov. Mentioned he's lost the 2 match tiebreaks that he's played to Tipsarevic and to Djokovic. Well read. Beautifully covered by
2-0
Tsijanović. So he just edges his nose ahead in this tiebreak. Aside from the match tiebreaks that Dimitrov has played, he traded breakers with Tsipsarevic in that match on Tuesday. Won the first, lost the second.
Fault. Yeah. 3-0
Double faults, though, for Janovic to take a 3-love lead in the breaker and to try and take this to another tiebreak. Rather more extended one, of course, in the final set. First two 10 points there. Oh. He hasn't got there yet.
3-1.
Brilliant from the Bulgarian.
Janovic.
Went for something similar. And couldn't quite control it. Their weight goes on.
Janovic.
Well, this particular tie break looks to be getting away from Dimitrov. It's the 11th match here at the Boodles this week. And so far, five of them have gone to match tie breaks. This could be the sixth. Needed that one. But two serves here for Janovic. If he can win both of them, he wins the tiebreak.
Punch.
5-3, Janovic.
Wasn't quite in his script.
What?
Rather more serious now in the breaker, isn't it? Rather than win both the points, Janovic has lost them both on his own serve there. Effectively now, that means that Dimitrov is back on serve in this tiebreak. Got both the mini breaks back.
Five all.
Got his game face on again. Four points in a row for Grigor Dimitrov in the tiebreak from 5-1 to 5-all. And so it goes
6-5.
On.
Dimitrov.
Long from Janovic. That's match point. Got long odds on this a few minutes ago. It's on the Janovic serve. And the fooling around has soon ceased.
Game, set a match.
And rather an unsatisfactory end for Janovic. He just seemed to 6-1. Give that away a little. And Dimitrov takes the straight sets victory in the end. Hugely entertaining affair, though. Played in a really good spirit between these two. High jinks, but also high quality. And Dimitrov comes through. His first win of the week. Didn't want the match tiebreak, having lost two of them already at this year's tournament.
Not allowed to go anywhere.
Didn't need it this time. Let's see
Hello,
what they thought about it.
Congratulations. Can you talk to me now? Are you going to sunbathe?
Hey.
You're quite tall. Shall I stand up here? Let's do this. That's better. Hello. Congratulations. You played very well.
I like your shoes.
Thank you. Oh. Okay. You just stay put. You played incredibly well today. I mean, you guys are obviously friends. What's it like playing against somebody who's such a joker?
Yeah, it was really fun. I know Grigor from juniors, so at least a few years. So it was really fun to play here. We'll see how it's gonna be. Right now, I had a few problems with my elbow. I didn't play for a few days, so it was really fun today, and I'm appreciated I had the opportunity to play this match.
And what's it like playing on grass? I mean, is it one of your favorite surfaces?
Almost. Next question.
Okay. Let's talk about that big serve that you've got. I mean, that's a pretty big serve.
Yeah. What do you want to know?
I mean, that's kind of your... I mean, that's where you go, isn't it? You're a bit of a bully with it. I mean, how can they compete against that?
As you can see, they can.
It's a very good point, actually. So you've got Wimbledon coming up next week. Are you excited?
Yeah, I'm really excited. Last year I had a few match points to go to fourth round, so I hope I will defend my points from last year.
And what's kind of up for the weekend? Are you going to be resting, playing computer games? You're going to have a drink? You're not allowed to have a drink. Don't look at me like that.
I cannot tell you. No, of course I will get few practices, as I said before. For sure, I'll get some treatment for my elbow, and I hope I'll be ready for next week.
And what do you think of the British crowd?
Unbelievable.
Are you going to be taking your shirt off at Wimbledon?
I don't think so, because I think I'll pay some fine.
I was going to say that. You actually owe me 20 quid for doing that. Not joking. Congratulations. Well done. You played really well today. Thank you. No trouble. Are you well?
Very good, thank you.
Played an excellent game.
Cheers, thank you. Thank you very much. Just want to thank all of you for this week. It's been an amazing week. Really happy to be here. Hopefully I can come back. And of course to the ball girls. They've been very helpful.
Well, the ball girls have been very helpful.
Yes, very helpful indeed on the court. So, yeah.
Now, there was obviously a lot of joking going on there. You know, you kind of climb behind there. But this is a tennis match, so you were determined to win?
Absolutely.
You guys are good friends. He said he's known you from juniors and stuff. I mean, it's obviously difficult, because once you get on the court, he's your competitor. Do you have problems with that, or you just didn't know and you're there to win?
I mean, no. But, you know, when you're on court, it's a different situation, obviously. And, I mean... Everyone want to win, so of course we're going to fight till the end, and I mean, we'll see in the future, and hopefully we're going to have many more matches to play, and you know, hopefully we're going to keep the fair play, so that's going to be a good, I think it's going to be a good call.
And Wimbledon next week, obviously it's our favourite 2 weeks of the year, I speak for myself, but it's a big tournament. Do you get pre-match nerves?
No, yeah, sort of. You get this gutsy feeling that you want to get on court and, you know, hit some balls, and it's never easy coming to Wimby, and you know, the weather can be a bit tricky.